the old-school adventure game, the name most people think of next to Tim Schafer is his fellow LucasArts alumni in Ron Gilbert. Ron was responsible for writing and directing the first two Monkey Island games, as well as other games like Day of the Tentacle and Deathspank. But in 2010, he went to work at Tim's studio, Double Fine, and while other teams there were working on their Kickstarter game, and their other Kickstarter game, Ron would start work on his own game for Double Fine. This is The Cave.
Welcome. Don't let my sultry and mysterious voice startle you. For hundreds, nay thousands, nay tens of thousands of years, people have come to me in search of what they desire most. Few find what they are looking for. Even fewer ever leave. Welcome to The Cave. That's me, The Cave. Yes, I'm a talking cave. Don't laugh. It makes dating hell.
So the talking cave, voiced by Stefan Stanton, introduces us to the seven characters, all stereotypical in nature, each on the hunt for what they desire most. To play the game, you need to select three characters and let them fall off the bridge into the depths of the cave and into the gift shop. Yeah, didn't you know? All caves have gift shops deep in its tunnels. For my playthrough, I chose the knight, the adventurer, and the time traveler, every character having their own special ability. The knight being able to create an invincibility shield when standing still, the time traveler being able to walk through walls, and the adventurer with her
grappling hook!
What? I like Gravity Falls! By the way, did you see that ending? Oh my god, I didn't see that coming. Each level was based upon cooperation. Using the D-pad, you switch between all three characters as you find objects and pull switches. However, I found the overall pacing of the game to be quite slow. You can die if you jump from too high of a surface, so ladders had to basically be climbed completely, and trying to get all three characters in the required place can be quite tiring. What would have been a nice feature would be a follow button, where if you hold it down, one character leads the other two, instead of having to do it three separate times. While on your journey, you come across cave paintings, which tell the backstories of our heroes, telling us about their desires, their jealousies, their deceivings, and they're all shown when the characters get their own levels detailing their life up until they decide to head to the cave. While the playable characters really lack any actual character outside of the cave paintings, other people that appear throughout the caves are actually quite funny. And let's not forget the narration of the cave itself that gives this game that old LucasArts feel.
I've played host to more truth seekers than any human would care to count, and I know an omen when I see it. Trust me, this is ominous. Ominous? Ominous. Ominous. Never mind.
However, and I hate spoiling things, there are two sets of endings. The corruption ending and the redemption ending. However, getting the good ending requires you to ask the souvenir cashier three times to return the prize. Something that after you get the ending, you can't just load your last save to get the other one. And naturally, after finishing, you'd want to play the game again with three other characters. Which begs the question, why do we have seven? The Cave is available on Steam, PSN, Xbox Live Arcade, and Wii U, with the Wii U version having the ability to switch characters via the gamepad, but no ability for off-screen, which would have been better. I've been doing this for 3 weeks now, and every game I've looked at was good but had flaws. Unfinished Swan was good but short, Quorum Conundrum was interesting but felt hollow next to its predecessor, and The Cave is funny but feels tedious. So what am I doing next week?
Life is like a hurricane here in Duckburg. Race cars, lasers, aeroplanes. It's a duck blur. Might solve a mystery or rewrite history. DuckTales, woo! Every day they're out.